Not many people in their careers can say they got to work with the most famous kangaroo of all time. I'm talking about Skippy, but we reckon Skip is pretty lucky too. He got to work with this guy, the legendary Tony Bonner.
Hey, Skip. Are you there, Skip?
Hey, you really do miss the family when they're away, don't you, Skip? I love there's no need for you to stay inside talking to yourself.
Oh, by the way, I've got a present for you.
From Maggie.
Oh, come on, you remember Maggie? The air hostess. That dizzy friend of mine that's always bringing you presents.
How lucky are we to have Tony Bonner joining us from Sydney. Such a pleasure. Hi!
I love it, man. I love it.
How do you feel when you hear the Skippy theme music playing? Is it a bit triggering, or does it take you back?
Well, no, I'll be brutally honest. I think of all the battles I had with a very fine barrister friend of mine, Rick Mitry, over trying to get some residual payments for not just myself but for my fellow actors from shows that had been on sold to this new electronic media. That none of those actors that did shows back in the 60s, 70s, into the 80s, received anything from the resale, the merchandising. So every time I hear Skippy, I have wonderful memories of the actors I worked with and the great crew back in those days. But I also have a little tang of, gee whiz, wouldn't it have been nice if we just had been all cut into the pie just a little bit.
Yeah. So true, but maybe the answer is a reboot, Tony. Television reboots are huge at the moment. What do you think about the return of Skippy?
Well, if you were in an Ange with that hot body of yours now, it'll be...
I'm lost for words.
You've made the promo, Tony. Congratulations. And our day. And her day.
Made my day. There's no question. Wow. I could be the answer to Clancy. I could be the new Clancy, mate.
Yeah.
Oh, well, there you go.
It could be.
Another classic, Tony, that you, of course, starred in was The Man from Snowy River, stellar cast as well. What's a magic moment from filming that with that special, special cast that you won't forget?
Well, you're correct. It was a hell of a film to do from a wonderful and iconic poem, obviously. Working with Kirk was interesting. It'll all be in my book one day, the actual working situation, but it was interesting to work with Kirk. It was just an iconic time to be on. Gus Mercurio, who was my very close and dear friend, Gus and I worked closely on that together. Simon Winsor, producer, George Noddy Miller, director, still all great pals of mine, you know, like 30, 40 years later. When that film went into America, I went over to do some filming there with Linda Evans on a series called The Last Frontier. And Snowy River opened in America at that same time, which was a blessing for me. And I had some nice reviews. The Hollywood Reporter mentioned, is this new young Aussie actor the new Clint Eastwood? You know, and we're talking like 40 years ago nearly now, or 35 years ago when that picture was released. So... I have nothing but fond memories from Snowy River. It was just great.
I'm pre-ordering that book you're writing. That sounds like it's got some good tales in it. But we have some great fan questions for you, Tony, if I can be so bold. These are from Studio 10's social media. Luke would like to ask, what did you think of the remake of the 90s version of Skippy that starred Andrew Clarke?
Yeah, well, Andy's a very close friend of mine, and Andrew played my kind of officer when we did the Anzacs, that wonderful 10-hour miniseries. Andrew was in that with me. I hope success for Andrew and the show in general, but I think they lost the essence of what the original show was about. Ange, the original show was about family. It kind of had a non-violent, or it wasn't tricky. It was just kind of pure, interesting entertainment. And that's why I think it still lasted. The new one that you're talking about now with Andy, I think they tried to make it a little too hip for the subject matter. If they had have kept the subject matter, I believe, in a simpler form, in a more honourable, honest form, I think it may have worked. It just got a little too tricky, I think.
Yeah, I've got a beautiful question here from Carol. She wanted to thank you. She has this signed photo of you saying, "Don't let the buggers get you down." She was getting bullied in high school and both her parents were sick with cancer and you helped her get through it all.
Well, I'm blessed that, and I hope she did, having not heard the result of that, but I've never been a fan of bullies, Ange, ever in my life. I've never backed away from a bully and I've supported anyone that needed to stand up to a bully. Bullies I hate. So I'm really honoured that she remembered, and I hope she survived and got stronger and sorted the bullies out in her life.
You're a good human, Tony
Very
Bonner.
Good human.
Thank you so much for being with us. We'll have to get you back here on the couch for a face-to-face catch-up
yes.
when it's COVID safe.
You're always trying to get me on the couch, man.
Should I leave? I might just leave.
I walked into that one. Hey,